Singing so long, it's been good to know you. So long, it's been good to know you. So long, it's been good to know you. There's a mighty big war that's got to be won. We'll get back together again.
Old devil time, I'm gonna fool you now. Old devil time, you'd like to bring me down when I'm feeling low. My lovers gather round and help me rise to fight you one more time. Old devil fear, you with your icy hand. Old devil fear, you'd like to freeze me cold. But when I'm afraid, my lovers gather round and help me rise to fight you one more time. Old devil, hey, I knew you long ago. Then I found out the poison in your breath. Now when I hear your lies, my lovers gather round and help me rise to fight you one more time. No storm or fire can ever bring us down. No wind that blows but carries us further on. Time, no storm or fire can ever bring us down. No wind that blows but carries us further on. And you who fear, oh lovers, gather round and we can rise to sing it one more time.
Plant the food, we drive the cab, we load the ship, we run the lab, we build the bridges, we fly the plane, we do the work, this is our day. Our day. We print the news, we clean the streets, we build the towers, we change the sheets, we write the books,
yes we do,
we lay the stone, we do the work, this is our home. The ditch.
Oh yeah.
We change the tire. We give the care. We fight the fire. We teach the kids. We lend a hand. We do the work. This is our land. We do the work. We do the work. We do the work. Our land. We type the page, we serve the meal, we sew the clothes, we mold the steel, we sell the goods, we pave the way, we do the work, this is our day. We do the work. I
Welcome to New York, my friends. Welcome to my town. Faster, there's Times Square and Fifth Avenue and the subway underground. There's the Brooklyn Bridge and the Empire State and festivals galore. And don't forget Miss Liberty, the queen of our nation's lore. Torchlight shining out to sea to guide far ships to our shore. Look around, my traveling friend, as you take in the sights. The colors on the marquees and the flashing Broadway lights. And if you walk the corridors of the Port Authority, can you fail to notice there amid the day's debris, the tired, the poor, the cast-offs who've no other place to be? What, my fellow citizens, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to be free? And as you take your noonday stroll, do you meet the outstretched hands, the swollen feet in bundled rags, and you wonder how they stand? Hungry children in the doorways, kids without a school. For if they have no place to live, then school's against the rules. Is this civilization, or is the nation run by fools? What, my fellow citizen, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe free? Who is he, that bent old man, so tattered and distraught? And who is she, the sister, whose life efforts came to naught? Have you gazed upon Miss Liberty and seen her shed a tear for the blasted hopes and the broken dreams of the homeless living here? Are the millions of life battles lost too much for her to bear? What, sing it, my fellow citizen, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe free? Your forefathers found a place to call their very own. When you were born, you had it good, and now that you are grown, you've come to see the very place beside the golden door, where those before you had arrived so wretched and so poor. While some came with a fortune and were welcomed at the shore, America is beautiful, that's what we're always told. For one who holds a silver spoon, the streets are paved with gold. A lucky star may light the way to opportunity, but the star might blink and cease to shine, and there is no guarantee that a cardboard box won't someday be a home for you or me. What, my fellow citizens, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe free? Hurry, hurry, hurry back to your own safety zone. Forget the ugly thought that you could be without a home. Yet wrapped secure in your four walls, these steps you may retrace and begin to ponder just how human is this human race. Dinner from a garbage can is a tough scene to erase. What, My fellow citizen, what is it you see? Do you see the huddled masses yearning to breathe free? Yearning to breathe free.
Thank you.
This is a song about the HUD scandal, the housing and urban development situation, which I wrote after listening to Sam Pierce take the Fifth Amendment 75 times. But for the title to this tune, everybody's gonna have to read my lips. It's called The Ballad of Silent Sam. Folks, I'm gonna sing a song about a man named Silent Sam. He ran the housing department, the world's quietest man. But that don't mean he's not honest. He's never told one lie. You can ask him anything, and here's how he'll reply. Seems that Sam's main job was making lots of loans. So rich folks got country clubs, and poor ones got no homes. Then Sam got a subpoena in Washington one day. So every single congressman got to hear him say, now when everyone who worked at HUD was wondering what Sam does, President Reagan was wondering who Sam was. Oh, by the way, I just wrote the verses for the song. Sam wrote the chorus. You know it. Sing along. Right on key. Now for jobs like Mr. Pierce's, we've gotta have more screening, 'cause silence is golden, now has a new meaning. But if he should ever choose to speak, we should say no thanks. Sam, we don't need no help filling in the blanks. Thank you. Thank you. My name is Joe Waldbaum. Thanks.
Do we have any school teachers in the house? Just raise your hand. Don't be ashamed. Yeah, it's a noble profession.
Here on the stage.
I did it for 18 years.
What did you do for 18 years?
I tried to teach somebody's children.
You must have taught someone.
I tried.
She was teacher of the year in the state of Virginia one year. You got to teach someone, you're going to be that, right? I sneaked it in again.
For all the school teachers. I said, Johnny's at the urinal, he's pissing on the wall. If he hits the radiator, we'll smell it in the hall. I got the school teacher blues.
I got the school teacher blues.
I got them school teacher blues. I got the school teacher blues. Nothing to lose but my pay. And that ain't nothing. You know my fingers have turned purple. My master's like I chewed it. My mind is getting warped from inhaling ditto fluid. School teacher blues.
I got the school teacher blues.
I got them school teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. Nothing to lose but my pay. And that ain't nothing. You know athletes, politicians, jet set, snort cocaine. All I snort is chalk dust is blowing out my brain. School teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. Nothing to lose but my pay. And that ain't nothing. They say that Johnny can't read, but what does Johnny have to know? Look at the competition, it's the age of video. School teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. Nothing to lose but my pay. And that ain't nothing. Proper when in public, don't know what parents might say. They don't pay me quite enough to make me act that way. School teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. Nothing to lose but my pay. And Ann's gonna tell you about it. Mediocrity, I points my finger to the home and I abuse hypocrisy. I got them school teacher blues. Yeah, I got them school teacher blues. I got them school teacher blues. Nothing to lose but my pay. School teachers, stand up. Yeah. Oh, don't be so ashamed. Yes, yeah, there you go. Congratulations.
All right, school teachers.
Election time. Well, there was two candidates trying to lay it on the line. One of them looked like he was training to be cute. He was a white man in a business suit. I looked at the other, he was equally astute. He was a white man in a business suit. Well, they kept on talking, they didn't make sense. They both seemed to be on the same side of the fence. There was no debate, it was a phony dispute. They were just two white men in business suits. You wanna be the president, you gotta learn to salute and be a white man in a business suit. It was a white man in a business suit. Well, every single one of them is in cahoots. He runs the USA, he's running Russia too. He's a white man in a business suit. Well, I went to the stream to get a little drink. Well, it was dark and dead, and it sure did stink. I went upstream to find the source of the spill. There was a chemical plant on top of a hill. I asked for the owner of this place of ill repute. He was a white man in a business suit. He was a white man in a business suit. The profits are his, it's our world that he pollutes. He'll never pay for his crimes, he's got a golden parachute. He's a white man in a business suit. Take it, Gene. Who was was after my loot. He was a white man in a business suit. I got fired by my boss because I wouldn't lick his boots. He was a I got evicted by my landlord cause my rent was overdue. He was a I got rejected for a loan at the financial institute by a I tried talking to my congressman, he didn't give a hoot. He was a so I went to a preacher, he just asked me to contribute. He was a they finally hauled me to a shrink. He said my case was acute. He was a white man in a business suit. Well, there's a whole lot of things I'd rather do than be a white man in a business suit. Well, I'd rather stay ragged and hirsute than be a white man in a business suit. Take it again. Just another uniform. It's a symbol of privilege and abuse. That's why they wear that business suit. Well, we need a role model that's a little more unique, instead of some obsessive money-hungry geek like a white man in a business suit. I wonder how many could fit in a telephone booth. Well, something must have to go wrong in your youth to be a yes, it's a white man in a business suit. He wants his control to be absolute. From Exxon and Chrysler to United Fruit, it's a white man in a business suit. Thank you.
All right. Here we are. It sometimes helps with some of these age-old positions that we have through being men and women. Sometimes nice idea to look at them in a different way, look at them in a different light, kind of say, well, if the shoe was on the other foot, and that's what this song is, if the shoe was on the other foot, how would we feel? And it's called B-Side. Ooh, 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 ooh. Is that right? Hello.
Hey.
There's something I've always wanted to say to you men. How would you like to hear this warning again and again? Look out, take care, beware, be careful whatever you do. Watch every step you take, or something could happen to you. Suppose that boys were made of sugar and spice, and girls were snails and puppy dogs' tails and nothing that's nice. They'd turn into women whose needs would be terribly hard to control. So you'd have to dress and behave like prisoners out on parole. Men, watch out, there's dangerous women about. Boys, beware, there's violent females everywhere. You read about rippers and rape in the news, then you hear the clatter of high-heeled shoes. Females are easily roused to passion and lust. You're asking for trouble, waiting alone at night for a bus. She could be the one that's right, the one you can't live without. She could be one of those ones your daddy warned you about. It could be a friend who threatens your body and life. It could be your teacher, your lover, your mother, your sister, your wife. She's used to the fact that you don't fight back or run or shout. She's one of those ones your daddy never warned you about. Men, watch out, there's dangerous women about. Boys, beware, there's violent females everywhere. They crawl along curbs in their Mercs and Jags. They goggle at porn and toy boy mags. They go to the football riot and then sing cigarettes, whiskey and wild, wild men. Cover your legs, remember to button your shirt. For if you're attacked and abused and you take the woman to court, the coppers are women, the judges are women who say you were dressed for sport. The doctors are women, the lawyers are women who say you were asking for it. Every time you open the paper and it's another man battered or raped and murdered and dumped in a ditch. Babies and boys and old, old men, when will it end? Degradation and fear and pain that women inflict on the men. Oh, what a crime, what a bloody disgrace to have to fear half of the human race. But look around, the lovely women about outnumber the dangerous, menacing ones, there's never a doubt. Do they raise their voices or try and find a cause or a cure? No, they only say, I'm not one of the dangerous ones for sure. Men for girls, there is no joke in this song. Boys for women, oppression has gone on far too long. Could you bear as we do here to walk and live and love in fear of dangerous men? A wave of sickness floods the land. The dole queue swallows the useless man. Aimless days, endless nights, bruised and battered children, battered wives, rape the land and kill the sea. Rape the women. The poor get poorer, the rich fly away. Kids learn that learning doesn't pay. Join the mob, buy and sell the world. Turn up the music and murder little girls. And murder. People turn against each other. Make a man feel less than human. He'll turn against himself and women.
So anyway, I think George Bush was trying to out Kennedy JFK recently, last year, when he song's about a program, I think, that really is an attempt to divert attention from the domestic problems that we face. And many of you maybe have not heard that this is actually all true, so I'll be the first to share it with you. I look around this world today and have to shake my head. A few folks live like kings and queens, while most are barely fed. There's homeless people everywhere and streets of gangs at war, epidemics of disease and oil spills on our shore. Our government is scandalized with corporate graft and greed. Our kids are leaving high school before they learn to read. Our people have been captured by terrorists and thugs who kill us with our weapons and then sell our children drugs. There's cult and racial murders, rape and child abuse, drums of toxic pesticides and nuke waste on the loose. There's carbonized pollution from 90 million cars. But Bush has the solution. We'll send a man to Mars. Oh, send a man to Mars. Send a man to Mars. Things are looking pretty good way up there in the stars. I'll gladly do my part to help and pay the tax I owe if George and Dan can be the first to go.
Now I wonder if the Martians have heard about this plan, and if they are preparing to be colonized by man. For answers to these questions, our interest here is large. Yes, George is really serious. He put Dan Quayle in charge. Oh, send a man to Mars, send a man to Mars. Things are looking pretty good way up there in the stars. I'll gladly do my part to help and pay the tax I owe if George and Dan can be the first to go. I think I've read this book before when I was just 13. It's called George Bush and His Electric Outer Space Machine. There might be life out there in space, there's some that say it's so. But if there is intelligence, how will Dan Quayle know? Send a man to Mars, send a man to Mars. Things are looking pretty good way up there in the stars. I'll gladly do my part to help and pay the tax I owe if George and Dan can be the first to go. Dan Quayle is ready to the task. George won't need to persuade, for any planet that is red is fair game to invade. A clever way for Bush to snub Noriega and his pals. Who needs Panama anyway? Mars has its own canals. Oh, send a man to Mars, send a man to Mars. Things are looking pretty good way up there in the stars. I'll gladly do my part to help and pay the tax I owe if George and Dan can be the first to go. What if they are captured by alien police and rot in Martian jails while we negotiate release? Maybe we can make a swap and send them Ronald Reagan. Better they should stay there, or we might send Carl Sagan. Send a man to Mars, send a man to Mars. Things are looking pretty good way up there in the stars. I'll gladly do my part to help and pay the tax I owe if George and Dan can be the first to go. So we'll plant our flag in Martian dust, and if it's not returned, George Bush can lie awake at night and pray it won't be burned. We'll give it all to science with none left to sustain us. Perhaps the Earth will straighten out before we reach Uranus. Send a man to Mars, send a man to Mars. Things are looking pretty good away up there in the stars. I'll gladly do my part to help and pay the tax I owe if George and Dan can be the first to go. Everybody, send a man to Mars, send a man to Mars. Things are looking pretty good way up there in the stars. I'll gladly do my part to help and pay the tax I owe if George and Dan can be the first to go. If George and Dan can be the first to go. If George and Dan can be the first up in the air, junior spacemen. If George and Dan can be the first to go.
All right. It's called Stealth Rag. I called my congressman the other day, but he didn't have a lot to say. So I gave him a piece of my mind, and with the piece that was left, I told him I thought that it was theft to spend $500 million on a plane, a stealth plane that we can't even see. Tell me, how's it gonna help us defend our country when the cadets go to fly 'em? They're gonna walk right by you. Well, this is what my telephone said to me. They're really there, but you just can't see them. You got to believe me when I say they're flying left and right. They just hang out of sight. You better get out. Clearwater, he does pretty good, huh? Well, I got me to thinking some about this whole stealth idea. Oh, wait, hold on, this is the wrong verse. Well, I hung up my telephone, and I had me this new idea. Why not build myself a brand new car? It'll be a stealth mobile, of course. So when the freeway looks like an obstacle course, I'm gonna have some fun down in New York. I'll be driving down that double yellow line. I'll make it down to work in record time, park where I want to. The radar cannot see me, so I can't commit a crime. And if a policeman asks me, this is what I'll say. I'm really there, but you just can't see. Ask the Pentagon. You got to believe me when I say, we're passing left and right. We're passing left and right. I just hang out of sight. You better get out of the way. You better get out of the way. Well, I got me to thinking some about this whole stealth idea. Realized it's been around for a long, long time. We've had stealth justice, stealth ethics, 1,000 stealth points of light, and worst of all, stealth people that we pass by. They're sleeping in the benches and the streets. They're holding out a cup and asking for something to eat. Politicians only see them when they're running for their seats. But I think that we can make them if we try. They're really there, but you just can't see. Got to believe, you got to believe me when I say, they're sleeping left and right, they're sleeping left and right. They just hang out of sight, you better. Got a note from the IRS. They said you're in trouble, boy. We haven't heard from you this year and we want to know why. I think they got a lot of nerve buying $1,000 toilet seats and then complain to me the kettle's dry. But they say they want some money that I've earned. They think that I got dollars to burn, burn, burn. But I paid them what I owe. As far as I'm concerned, last April I sent them a stealth return. It's really there, but you just can't see. Got to believe, you got to believe me when I say, we're paying left and right. They're paying left and right. Spending out of sight, I'm waiting for changes any day. But till then, just stay out of my way. It's really there, it's really there, it's really there, it's really there. You got to believe me when I say, I am left and right. Just hang out of sight. Better get out of the way.
And thanks, Travis Jeffries.
I wrote this. It's new. It's called Swimming to the Other Side.
Living beneath the great big dipper, we are washed by the very same rain. We are swimming in the stream together, some in power and others in pain. We can worship this ground we walk on, cherishing the beings that we live beside. Loving spirits will live forever. We're all swimming to the other side. I am alone and I'm searching, hungering for answers in my time. I am balanced at the brink of wisdom. I'm impatient to receive a sign. I move forward with my senses open. Imperfection, it be my crime. In humility, I will listen. We're all swimming to the other side. We are living 'neath the great big dipper. We are washed by the very same rain. We are swimming in the stream together, some in power and others in pain. We can worship this ground we walk on, cherishing the beings that we live beside. Loving spirits will live forever. We're all swimming to the other side. On this journey through thoughts and feelings, finding intuition, my head, my heart, I am gathering the tools together. I'm preparing to do my part. All of those who have come before me, band together and be my guide. Loving lessons that I will follow. We're all swimming to the other side. We are living 'neath the great big dipper. We are washed by the very same rain. We are swimming in the stream together, some in power and others in pain. We can worship this ground we walk on, cherishing the beings that we live beside. Loving spirits will live forever. We're all swimming to the other side. When we get there, we'll discover all of the gifts we've been given to share have been with us since life's beginning, and we never noticed they were there. We can balance at the brink of wisdom, never recognizing that we've arrived. Loving spirits will live together. We're all living on the other side. We are swimming 'neath the great big dipper. We are washed by the very same rain. We are swimming in the stream together, some in power and others in pain. We can worship this ground we walk on, cherishing the beings that we live beside. Loving spirits will live forever. We're all swimming to the other side. We are living 'neath the great big dipper. We are washed by the very same rain. We are swimming in the stream together, some in power and others in pain. We can worship this ground we walk on, cherishing the beings that we live beside. Loving spirits will live forever. We're all swimming to the other side. Loving spirits will live forever. We're all swimming to the other side.
Thank you.
I got the news that the war had begun. Straight for the army, all that I run. All of the people in my hometown was a-running up and a-running down, singing, so long, it's been good to know ye. So long, it's been good to know ye. So long, it's been good to know ye. There's a mighty big war that's got to be won. We'll get back together again. Crowd was packed by the railroad track. People was a-yelling and a-patting my back. While the engineer rung his bell, I hugged all the mothers and kissed all the gals, singing, so long, it's been good to know ye. So long, it's been good to know ye. So long, it's been good to know ye. There's a mighty big war that's got to be won. We'll get back together again.